Hi, welcome again to the Hongying School. So today I'm not going to show you any techniques or any weapons or any boxing or anything. Today I want to talk to you about the other side of training. So we say there are three aspects which we need to focus on for our training. The first of those is physical. Physical training is quite easy. Whatever your chosen sport is, you put on your clothes, you go to your gym or to your wherever it is, your football field, or in my case, here in the school, and you do your training, okay? Then you go off and you carry on with the rest of your life. So that's the physical training. The key to that is regularity and hard work, okay? And routine. Now, routine is a key word. The other sides of training, which are much more difficult to deal with, especially in this day and age when people are under such pressure, are the mental and emotional training. So, in Chinese philosophy, we talk about three treasures: physical, mental, and emotional. And it's the mental and emotional side that's going to get you into problems or going to create stress in your life or cause you to sometimes maybe feel depressed or like you're losing your direction or any of those things. So, a few key things that you need to start working on right today, straight away. Employ this today. The first of those is discipline, mental discipline. Focus on the things which matter to your life, the things that you can actually influence. Don't spend too much time, and preferably no time, thinking about stuff that you can't influence, or things that you don't have yet, or places that you're not yet at in your life. Focus on where you are today. Be disciplined in your thought patterns. Don't allow yourself to wander. If you have a problem, face the problem, look at it directly. We call that facing your dragons. There's no point. If you have a letter from the bank or from your boss or even from your girlfriend, don't put that letter away. Look at it, face it, it's reality. It might not be the reality that you want to face, but it's somebody else's reality, the person that wrote that letter to you. So you've got to deal with it. You need to be disciplined. And the only way to do that is to train yourself. Train yourself to try and be routine every day in the way you approach your day, in the way you plan out the things that you have to do, and try to balance those things with the things that you want to do. This is going to give you a little bit more emotional satisfaction. If you spend all day under the hammer and you never do anything you like, then you're going to feel like you're under the hammer all the time. So what you're going to do, think, okay, which things do I have to do? Which things do I want to do? Let's do the things we have to do first. If the pile's too big, then we just allot some time to that. So for example, I hate bookkeeping, okay? I love training, I love fighting, I love everything else I do in my life, but I hate bookkeeping. But our organization is quite a big organization, different schools, lots of students. My calendar is very busy, very full, so I have to do some administration every day, or I'm going to end up down the road in all kinds of problems. So, what do? The pile never gets any smaller, because every time I work something off it, something comes on top. So what we do, just put some time in it. So let's say you're going to spend an hour or 2 hours doing some administration. Then you go off and do something you want to do, something you enjoy. Then you gotta go do the shopping. Okay, give that some time. Then do something else you enjoy, etc., etc. And work your way through the day like this. And then you'll find that all the things in your life get the attention they need. But like I said, this is hard because it takes discipline. It takes mental discipline every day, and you have to stay positive and believe that you are going to get through your problems, Only you can solve these things, because nobody is going to come and do it for you, okay? So what you've got to do is start getting the same discipline in the rest of your life that you have with your training. It's exactly the same. It's just a different thing, different aspects. If you can apply this to your whole life, you'll find that everything will start to go a little smoother, okay? In a few weeks, I'll try to do another little video like this, talk about some of the other problems that people are facing, some of the things that people ask me, some of the things that the students ask me. Basically, all you need to do is set in that routine every day. Balance things out between the stuff that you have to do and the stuff you want to do. Give yourself rewards for every time you do something difficult, or you deal with some work, or you pay all your bills, or whatever it is. Okay? So make it a fair race for yourself. Don't let yourself sit under that hammer, because it will keep banging on top of your head every day if you let it. Okay? And sticking your head in the sand is not going to solve any problems. Certainly not for you. Okay? You need to get up and be positive. Negative is an easy choice. Oh, I feel bad. Oh, I feel sorry for myself. Oh, I don't have any money. Oh, I don't have a girlfriend. Whatever it is. I didn't reach this rank yet. Or I want to be this. Or I want to be that. It's very easy to go down that street. It's a little more difficult and takes a little more discipline to say, you know what? Everything I do today is going to be in a positive energy. I'm going to take the positive out of every situation, look for the silver lining behind every cloud, and that will change the way you feel as you move through your day. Also, it's a fact. When you try to generate positive energy, you create positive energy within yourself, okay? Then you feel better. You feel more energetic. You move through your day better, okay? Discipline, mental training, emotional balance. Good luck.